Alrighty, hey guys, this is Pieter from Techno Cocktail, and today I am going to be showing you guys cable management in my new gaming computer. So what I've done right now is I have unplugged everything. All of this is just loose cables coming out of the power supply, or the case itself. Now, the cables that are coming out of the roof of the Cooler Master Storm Enforcer is USB 3, USB, and HD audio. That's it. That's all that's coming out of the roof on the front side. What's coming out of my power supply? 24-pin SATA, Molex, PCIe 6 or 8-pin SATA, your 4 or 8-pin for your motherboard, Molex, and another PCIe 6 or 8 pin. Now, what I'm going to be doing first is I'm going to be routing all these cables to the back. What I'm going to do is I'm going to be using this bottom hole over here. So, I'm slide it a bit closer for you guys. I am going to be using this hole behind the SSD. First, let's start off with the big cable, the 24 pin cable. And what I'm going to do is just route it through and leave it there. I'll show you what I'll do with them in just a sec. Route it through and leave it. Route it through, leave it. Now what I'm doing right now is, you see, I'm taking cables and leaving them. It's just the way they've been lying in for a while now, so I'm trying to keep them coming out of the power supply in the same way as they're going into the back of the case. Now, most cases these days, just like this Storm Enforcer, have spaces behind the motherboard tray and hard drive rails and whatever to allow you to have some cable management. Because if you don't have cable management, the point of this fan is useless. So, top cables here, just going to be routing these through this hole at the top here. There we go. Like this one as well. Pull it through, and there you go. Everything is at the back. Now there are still two cables hanging here at the front. This one is coming from the fan that's blowing at the radiator, and this one, the 3-pin, is coming off the H60 cooling. Now, what Corsair recommends is that you plug in this 4-pin fan into the CPU fan slot. I'm sorry, into a normal fan slot. So I'm just looking through the top here now, just to see this. Just wait, I'll be right back just to check if I'm doing this right. Alright, I was correct. The chassis fan, the fan that is blowing in here needs to go into the CPU fan slot to be able to determine temperatures and that kind of stuff. Then this one's coming out of the water block. So I'm going to put this into chassis fan 1. Now you'll notice this one's a 3-pin. You just have to plug it into the left side and ignore the 4th pin. Okay, so that's those two fans done. Now I'm just going to try to hide these cables by pushing them up here. Through here, since there's a grommet up here as well, just a hole in the roof of the case. I'm just going to route it up here, try and pull it down to the back, and make it look neater. Now I'm just going to unplug this one again so that this goes out of the way. Plug it back in. Now you'll notice these are black cables, so it already looks quite nice in my basically all black design on my computer. Same principle with this cable here. I'm trying to keep cables and any water pipes or anything like that not hitting this top fan over here. What I've done with the top fan is I've routed the cable so it comes out over here at the top near the back, and it comes out through the back through that top hole as well. Now you'll see there's no more cables dangling out, and that's it for the front side. We'll be returning here in a while after we start routing everything to the correct place. So I'm just going to grab the case now and I'm going to flip it around so you guys can see what I'm doing. There you go. That's the back of the case. Now this is with the back the right panel taken off. Now, here you've got color cables. Leave that for now. This cable here, three colors, three pin, PWM, is for the 200 millimeter fan at the front. This one is for that 120 millimeter we put at the top. These two cables are those ones we tried to hide up there for the water block and the fan for it. Now, these cables I've already told you about. These are the USB 3, USB, and audio. We're going to leave these as well for now. Now, your best friend during things like this should be zip ties. They come with basically every computer product you will buy that has a cable attached to it. So, these are just the case cable ties. Now, cool thing about this case here is you can just stick cable ties through here and tie it up. Now, this case has about 1.5 centimeters of space at the back for you to route your cables through. Now, I know this off by heart already, but on your motherboard this may differ. Up here is my 8-pin motherboard port. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to route it under this whole bunch, since it's going that way, and route it through this grommet over here, which is just the right size to fit this through. On the other side, I am just grabbing it and pulling it a bit down for later use. Now you'll see it's just jumping back a bit because it doesn't want to go there. But I'm just going to leave it like that for now. Secondly is our mammoth of a cable, the 24-pin. Now, the 24-pin on this motherboard is over here-ish. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick it through here and just leave that as it is. Oh, wait, sorry. I'm going to take it and route it over this whole bunch of cables without losing that cable tie. Stick it through here and leave it. Next, let's take a SATA connector. So I'm going to be hooking up my hard drive and my SSD, which is down here, with my hard drive over here, onto one cable, and then my CD drive onto another one, since there's two SATA cables that come with this Corsair power supply. So first of all, I'm going to check the L on this bracket, so it goes in like this. Put that back through the original hole. Now, you may be thinking, why'd you take it out then? It's so I can still cable manage it. Then, bring it up here, take the cable, without putting too many twists in the cable, put it somewhat like that. Now you'll see, I'm going to remove this one, since I chose basically the wrong one. Put this over there. And it isn't in our way. Now I'm going to try get the closest one that will fit. So that's going to be the second one after the end one, which I used for my SSD. So now I can just route it like that, and then reroute it later on. Now, you'll see we have these, at the moment, useless cables. What you could use them for is if you don't have enough plugs for all your fans that you've installed, you could use these handy adapters that came with the case that were plugged into the fans standardly. I've just taken them off, and you could plug that in there, but I'm not going to since I can fit all my fans onto my motherboard. I'm just going to move these zip ties
No. There we go. Now, I said I'm going to take the other Seda, or Sada, or however you prefer to say it. Take it. I'm going to be using the end one again. And I'm going to route it through this top one like that. Now, what do we have left that we're going to use? Is another one of these Merlikes, another one of the Merlikes. We don't need those. And two PCIe's. Now, my graphics card is right there. So what I'm going to be doing is writing them where the 24-pin port. There you go, routed. Now you may be wondering, what's he going to do with this, with these two Molex ports, plugs and wires? Well, I'm just going to be hiding them down there. Now the fun part starts. We get to route our, we get to turn around the case and route some cables. You may be thinking, you just routed those cables. Exactly. Now it's time to plug them in. There we go. Put all the cables still in the holes that you want them to go in. I put my Q connector aside. All the cables, there we go. Now, you may recall me telling you that the 24 pin goes over here. So, just plug that in. Now you may see I'm just plugging it in quite unneatly right now. That's because I'm going to be pulling on them a bit later. Okay, put my SATA up in here, 24 pin in here, and just pull it a bit away so it looks a bit neater. Now, PWM, hard port to hide. Now, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking these extra two pins and wrapping it around it like that. And put it in, and I'm just going to stick it under my cooler like that. Same with the other one, and just stick it in the cooler. Now, I'm not going to do that yet. Now, take the two cables. Now, just for aesthetic reasons, I'm going to be making them look like one cable. So what I'm going to do, use a zip tie. So, lightly pull on the zip tie, put the cables in the way you'd want them to go. Pull a bit more on the zip tie. Of course, making sure that you're not breaking any of the pins in the plugs. Here, and we'll cut this off later. There you go, one nicely looking bunch of cables. Now, that's all plugged in. Up here is my 8-pin power, which is hiding from me. And now I'm just unwrapping it. Ugh, this is what happens when you curl that fan up in there. Be right back. No, just kidding. There we go. Great. There we go. Got the 8 pins in here. Twist it around to the right direction. Plug it in. Now remember, all your cables should be obtaining a bit of slack, because you don't want them to break the pins or anything. Now this may be quite a long video, just like the assembly guide. Now this 8-pin for me is one of the hardest to do. As you can see, I'm typically failing at it. It's because there's too much stuff everywhere. There you go. It's enough. Okay, so just pull that on, make sure the fan doesn't touch it. And there we go. That's the 8-pin power done. So what we've done now is we've plugged in our PCIe, our 24-pin, our SATA up here. Our SATA was already plugged into our SSD down here. Then we've plugged in all our ports at the front and our 8-pin at the top. Now let's turn around the case again and continue with a bit of routing and zip ties. But first, I'm going to get my trusty friend here. The scissors on my knife, and just cut that off nice and short, so it looks nice. There you go, let's turn around the case. Careful not to jerk on any of the cables that are plugged into it, alright? And there we go. Now, this one's plugged in, this one's plugged in, this one's plugged in. Now what you're going to be doing is you're going to be taking these cables, you're going to be extending them a bit, so they're quite stretch as such. You're going to take a zip tie, stick it through one of these grommets. I don't know if my head's in the way. There you go. Take the two cables you want together. You don't necessarily have to put two cables in one, but just for this case, I'm going to be doing that anyway. Make sure they're routed nicely before you fully fasten them. And there you go. That's that done. I'm just hoping that my case will close after I'm done with this. So that'd be a horrible thing to happen if it didn't. Now I'm just going to be hiding this cable up here. This one I'll leave dangling. Now, next cable we're going to be routing. We're going to just move these cables out of the way. So, next cable we're going to be routing is this one. This one's fine already, so we're just going to put that down there. Not everything you do needs a zip tie. Then, our two PCI ones. I'm going to just be zip tying those two up here, making sure that they've got a bit of slack on the other side. Taking the zip tie. Now, thanks to Cooler Master or CM Storm, however you want to refer to them. They have quite a lot of these zip tie points, just like Corsair cases do, and that's a good thing. Trust me, it is. It makes your case look a hell of a lot neater. The end. Good. Make sure this 8-pin over here, something like that. Go. There you go. Now you can see these two cables here. I'm just going to be pushing those through here, since I'm going to be hiding those away on this side of the case. Now this cable we can just push a bit up here, like so. And then these ones, we're just going to wind up as such. Now I'm going to put a zip tie around these, just to make sure that they don't move. There you don't want your cables that are like this, just start moving and jiggling around. Cut it off. And I'm going to stick it down here in those permanent hard drive brays. There we go. Next is this SATA cable over here. So, as I said, not everything needs a zip tie. Now there's another point for zip tying up here. So I'm going to wrap this cable as such and zip tie another one up there. Now I know I just said not everything needs a zip tie, but come on. We won't die from using a bit of zip ties, will we? Exactly. They're our friend. A very, very good friend. Now, if you guys are wondering, you can expect much more content after this computer is finished. By the time you're watching this, it's probably been finished for about a month or so. But that's beside the point. Here we go. SATA cable nicely routed from the top here. And zip tied stuck in its folded position. Now we're just going to add a bit more zip ties to this 24 pin and our PCIe's. And then we're done with the power supply cables. Here. Now I am putting quite a lot of zip ties on this 24 pin. That's because it's the freaking fattest cable in the whole computer. That doesn't have much to do with it, but there we go. 8 pin out of the way. This is gonna be a tight fit. Should fit though. I'm gonna be trying to hide and layer these cables as efficiently as possible. See, these are different lengths, obviously, because they're being plugged in at two different points on the other side of the case. Zip tie. Zip tie mania! It's like they were free, which they were! Anyway, I'm going to try and route that a bit nicer out of the power supply itself. Stop being so stubborn. I don't think that was a very smart one. Anyway, we'll see when we close it up. I routed that one nicely at all. There you go, that's all the basic routing for your power supply cables. Now what we're going to be doing next is our USB and our HD audio, our front fan, our colorful Christmas wires, and we're all going to be routing that in the same kind of fashion into PWM ports on this motherboard. So I'm going to turn around the case, stick through the cables in their appropriate locations, which you should be able to do now, or I'll just show you. So, my USB 3 motherboard, on this motherboard, is here. So route it through, leave it. Then, let's see, USB and HD audio. Now, I'm just gonna go look on the other side where this is quickly. USB, USB, HD audio. Yeah. Okay, so these, I'm gonna be writing out in the same place. Down here, where all the cables came out for the motherboard, from the power supply. So those will be routed out there. Then, this PWM fan here will be routed out straight here, where it just reaches. And this one will be routed out. This is the front fan. This one will be routed out down here, like that. And then these plugs, down here. Then these plugs, which you now know as the Christmas lights, I'll be going to last. So, step around the case, and I keep pulling out that fan. And you'll see now why I'm going to that last cable, to those Christmas cables last. Okay, so let's start with the fan. This fan, just route it up, cross through here, plug it in next to that Momo cable. If I could fit my hand in there. There we go. Again. Just pull on that a bit, like so, and that's it. Then, USB 3, I'm going to pull this out back into the to the back of the case a bit, and then the notch on the side of the USB 3 cable here goes into the hole on this side, which is facing away from the motherboard, as such, and it just bonks in like so. Then, down here, so front fan, which will be plugged in over there, so I'm just going to pre-wrap this down here as well. And plug it in over there, if it's willing to cooperate. There we go. Now, HD audio. I need to check which one of those is HD audio. USB, that goes here. I'm gonna be putting it over there for aesthetic reasons. There's no real big difference in which one you plug it into. Then HD audio, that goes all the way down there, which is quite far apparently to this cable. I'm sorry that you guys can't see much of this, but I can hardly see it as well. I think. Yeah, there we go. It's in. Thank goodness. Yeah, I'm just gonna check. There we go. That one won't be needing a zip tie. Okay. Just like that. And this cable that's hanging underneath it, I'm just gonna hide over there under the PCI slots. I'm gonna unplug the fan and the USB quickly so I can hide the audio cable underneath all of this. And then just re-plug in the fan and the USB. There we go. Routed. Now basically, we're done now, except for one thing. Well, a few more things actually. It's
Donna, and this, our favorite little thingy, which is where our Christmas tree comes in. Woohoo! So we're finally going to be wiring up our Christmas lights. So turn on the case again. And our Christmas lights appear. Now, every connector on the Christmas lights has a label. Now, if you get out the instruction manual for your case, as such, you will get the installation guide for all the pins. In multiple languages, even. Yay, our favorite. As well. Now, I am just checking something. Sorry about this, guys. Okay, basically, it doesn't tell. So, what this is telling me is that minus is going to be the white cables. Good. Okay, so here it is, power LED minus and power LED plus, and then on here you've got letters and names as well. Now here you go, power LED minus and plus, so plug in minus there, and plus, so. Speaker. Now, with this case, that is something separate, so I will be plugging that in. And I'll be hiding it later. So, take it, it goes like that. Now we're going to turn it around. The rest of our Christmas tree goes in. Reset and ground. So, reset. That is this blue and white one. Now, ground, in this case, would be negative. So, just plug that in. Well, it doesn't really matter because the switch just is like that. Power switch. So just put that in there. And then our hard drive LED lights. And that goes in as such as well. There we go. That's it. That's what Q connectors are for. As you can see, that's full now. Full of plugs. Now, what the thing is, what ASUS is trying to say about their Q connectors is, flip your case around, stick your entire Q connector system through a grommet. I'm going to be using the bottom one again. Then, you'll see there are many holes blocked out on this one, and you're going to want to see which ones don't have pins on the motherboard itself. Swap it the right way, plug it in, you're done. That's it. That's all for that. Just hide that away. Speaker, I'm just going to also put down there for now. Now, we flip it back around to the last bit of cable tying, and then my computer is done. Now, these I'm all just gonna bunch up like this, take up here along with the fan header, basically all the cables that are coming out of there that aren't already cable tied to anything. There we go. Put that around all the cables. And you know what to do now. Just pull on all the cables until it's nice and neat on the other side. Just checking. For instance, my USB one is a bit too tight for now. There you go.
Just do another last check, and I'm fine. Fully tighten it, and there you go. That's that. Now, since there's so many of these buggers, I'm gonna be routing them all to the top here. See that they're in a single line. The fan at this point I'm just going to be leaving. And take the cables. Now since this doesn't have to be perfect, I'm just going to wrap it around like this. To the highest point where I can wrap it neatly. And voila, I'm out of cable ties. So, what else? Time to start cutting off all of these. The reason I ran out of cable ties now is because I'm only using the ones that came with the case. So I'll go get some more out of another product's box quickly. Here we go. Just like so. Be right back with some more cable ties.